Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. May the peace, mercy and blessings of Allah be upon all of you. Today the world is celebrating Mother's Day. For Muslims, every day is a Mother's Day. In Islam, the mother has a very high status. Here are some verses from the Quran and some hadiths about the status of a mother in Islam. Allah says in Surah Al-Ahqaf, chapter number 46, verse number 15, Allah says, "We have enjoined on man kindness to his parents. In pain did his mother bear him, and in pain did she give him birth." Here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is emphasizing the trouble the mother has to go through. In the Holy Quran, Surah Al-Isra, chapter number 17, verse number 23 and 24, Allah says, "Your Lord has decreed that you worship none but him, and that you be kind to parents. Whether one or both of them attain old age in your life, say not to them a word of contempt, nor repel them, but address them in terms of honor, and out of kindness, lower to them the wing of humility, and say, Rabbirhamhuma kama rabbayani saghira. Say, My Lord, bestow on them Thy mercy, even as they cherished me in childhood." Allah says in chapter number 31, verse number 14 and 15, Allah says, "We have enjoined on man to be good to his parents. Show gratitude to me and to your parents. To me is your final goal. But if your parents strive to make you join in worship other things of which you have no knowledge, obey them not, yet bear them company in this life with justice and consideration, and follow the way of those who turn to me in love." Now here are a few hadiths about the status of the mother. Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, said, "The heaven lies under the feet of your mother," as mentioned in Ahmad and Nasai. It is mentioned in Sahih al-Bukhari and Sahih Muslim, a man came to the Prophet and said, "O Messenger of God, who among the people is the most worthy of my good companionship?" The Prophet said, "Your mother." The man asked him for the second time, "Then who?" The Prophet said, "Then your mother." The man further asked for the third time, "Then who?" The Prophet replied, "Then your mother." The man asked for the fourth time, "Then who?" The Prophet, peace be upon him, said, "Then your father." It is mentioned in Abu Dawud and Ibn Majah, Abu Usaid radiallahu anhu said, "We were once sitting with Rasulullah when a man from the tribe of Salma came and said to him, 'O Messenger of Allah, do my parents have rights over me even after they have died?' The Prophet said, 'Yes, you may pray to Allah to bless them with forgiveness and mercy. Fulfill the promises they have made to anyone and respect their relations and their friends.'" It is mentioned in Sahih al-Bukhari and Sahih Muslim, Abdullah ibn Amr radiallahu anhu narrates that the Prophet, peace be upon him, said, "The major sins are to believe that Allah has partners, to disobey one's parents, to commit murder, and to bear false witness." In another hadith in Sahih Muslim, book number 32, hadith number 6189, Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu reported, Allah's messenger said, "Let him be humbled into the dust." That is, let him be destroyed. Again he repeated, "Let him be humbled into the dust." The people asked him, "O Allah's messenger, who is he?" The Prophet said, "He who sees either of his parents during their old age, or he sees both of them, but he does not enter paradise." Here is a story which shows the high status of the mother. The story of Uwais al-Qarni, as mentioned in Sahih al-Muslim. Uwais al-Qarni was born in the Asir region of Arabia. Even though he was from the Tabi'in, and did not see the Messenger of Allah, The Messenger of Allah had advised Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu anhu that if he meets him, he should ask forgiveness of Allah through him. Why? Uwais had a profound love for Islam and the Messenger of Allah. Uwais learned that there is a great reward in Islam for serving parents. He had a mother who was sick and blind, so he devoted himself solely to the service of his mother. And because of his service to his mother, Allah's Prophet is telling Umar radiallahu anhu to ask him to pray to Allah to forgive him, to forgive Umar radiallahu anhu. Umar radiallahu anhu narrates, "I heard the Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, say, Uwais ibn Amir will come to you with the delegations from Yemen, from Murad, then from Karn. Uwais was once afflicted with leprosy and his skin healed except for a dirham's area. He has a mother and he treats her kindly. If he was to ever swear by Allah for something, Allah would fulfill his oath. If you can request him that he ask forgiveness for you, ask him. Every year at Hajj time, Umar would inquire about him from the visiting tribes until one day he met him. He said, are you Uwais al-Karni? He said, yes. Umar continued, from Murad, then from Karn? He said, yes. Umar then asked, were you once afflicted with leprosy and your skin healed except for a dirham's area? Uwais said, yes. Umar finally asked, do you have a mother that is alive? He said, yes. Umar then requested from Uwais, ask forgiveness for me to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Uwais did it. This shows the high status Islam awards the mother. So for Muslims, every day is a mother's day.